Check 1, 2. Check, check. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay.
I was dressed as well. All right, good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Fulton Street Collective. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. If you're joining us online, we're coming to you live from the beautiful city, the sunny city, where the weather's always nice, Chicago, Illinois. If you're in the house, you know where you are. Tonight, we're proud to present two bands. The first band is Paul Perlis Trio, and then the second is Gwen's Pat Metheny Project. We're starting with Paul's crew first. As we do with all our performances here, always accompanied by a visual artist. Tonight's visual artist, give it up for Betty Heredia. If you are watching from home, she is in the lower left-hand side of your screen. She's going to be painting and sketching the band as they perform. And what's really cool is in the lower right-hand side of your screen. That's how you buy your art, buy her artwork. That's also how you tip and donate to the bands tonight. So please be generous and kind. Be supportive. Feel like we're taking a step back here in the world. So we're going to be still live streaming everything for a while. So please support the arts. All right, we're going to start the show now on On bass is Ethan Fillion. Piano, Julius Tucker. And drums and compositions, Paul Perlis. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Paul Perelis. We are the Paul Perelis Trio. This is a special night for us because this is actually the debut performance of this piano trio. I've always really enjoyed the piano trio format in this music, and I'm happy to tonight lead my own piano trio for the first time, accompanied by these great musicians. So I want to thank you guys for playing with me. This has been awesome. And those first two compositions you heard, the first one was entitled Reaching Forth by the great pianist McCoy Tyner off of his 1963 album, Reaching Forth. And that second composition was actually a Tony Williams tune entitled Sister Cheryl. And that was off of his, I believe it was 1985 record, Foreign Intrigue. And next we're gonna play a classic by Marvin Fisher entitled When Sunny Gets Blue. And this specific arrangement was done by Donald Byrd on his record, Donald Byrd Live at the Half Note, and this is volume 2. So we hope you enjoy. This is When Sunny Gets Blue. Thank you. Thank you guys again. That was Thelonious Monk's Evidence. And now we're going to move on to a song called, well, you would know it if you know the musical production Camelot. I believe it starts Act Two. And this is called If Ever I Would Leave You. And my fiance Natalie has asked me to play the song for quite a while because it's one of her favorite standards. And so I finally decided to transcribe it. And yeah, so this one's gonna be for Natalie. We're actually getting married next month. So we're, thank you. So we're knee deep in wedding planning. But this is for you, Natalie. This is If Ever I Would Leave You by Frederick Lowe.
Thank you.
Thank you guys again so much. We're gonna play like a minute and a half, maybe 2 minute long tune before our set is up. And then we're gonna welcome Amy Naraki and her wonderful Pat Metheny project. You guys are really gonna enjoy it. I saw them play like 2 years ago now when I opened for their first show here. And they did a wonderful job of interpreting Pat Metheny's beautiful music. But we're gonna close out our set with a tune by Kenny Dorham called Straight Ahead. Once again, we are the Paul Perellis Project. Give it up one more time for Ethan Filling on the bass and Julius Tucker on the piano. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
This is everybody. This is me. All right. That's Ethan Fillion on bass. Julius Tucker, piano. Paul Perlis, drums and compositions. We're going to take a short break and then bring up Gwen's Pat Metheny project. If you're in the house, we're going to turn on the lights, check out the artwork that Betty has been doing. Check out the artwork all around you. If you're at home, you can check out Betty's artwork on the lower left-hand side of your screen. And what's a better part of your screen is the lower right-hand side of your screen. That's the virtual tip jar. Please be generous. Please tip the band. Please donate to the artist. If you like what you see in here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective so we can keep doing these performances. We're going to see in about 15 minutes. Stick around. Let's give it one more time for the band. Paul Perlis.
You playing that UV there. Oh, yeah. It's that's a tricky instrument. It's not at all like an actual one.
Oh, no.
No. Not at all.
Give me a flag.
Hey, thanks for spinning.
Into it too.
Yeah.
It'll be a great time, but thank you for playing so much. nice to have something to hold you over.
Exactly. Who knows?
Black folder. Alright. Hey, Amy.
What's up?
I got the music, but my folder's missing.
Can you check the bag?
Thank you. are too nice to steal music.
All right, we're back. Welcome to band number two. Yeah, two bands tonight. Two bands for the price of one. Price is so low, they are
insane.
That's right. Tonight we are proud to present Gwen's Pat Metheny project. Give it up. On drums is TJ Thompson. Vinny Cabot on bass. Trevor Hill, saxophone. Juliet Gardner, trumpet. Leading the crew tonight on guitar, Amy Nuraki.
Thank you.
This is kind of awkward because the last time I played here, there wasn't a mic, which meant I could keep my note sheet on my music stand and nobody would know ahead of time. But here we are. So that was, well, I'll introduce the band again, but you heard Juliet on trumpet, Trevor on sax, Vinny on bass, and TJ on drums. I wanted to thank everyone for coming out and sticking around, and of course for the Paul Pareles trio to play beforehand. That was like a fine, expensive glass of wine listening to you. I feel bad for whoever missed it. So you just heard Come and See. Like Chris said before, this is Gwen's Pat Metheny project. If there's anything you don't like, file all complaints to Gwen. I will give you her email after the show. And Come and See is off of the Unity Band album from Pat Metheny. You can also find it on his Unity Sessions album. It's kind of from later in his career. And, well, I think all of his stuff is high energy, but especially for that stuff, it's pretty high energy. So now we're going to carry on here, and we're going to go ahead and play Question and Answer. Some of you might be familiar with that, but Pat Metheny's kind of made his way in to the jazz audience, so to speak, and jazz musicians have tunes that are good for them to know, and Question and Answer has kind of made its way into that. So we're going to play that now. Hope you enjoy. that was question and answer. Now we're going to move on to the beginning of Pat Metheny's career and play Bright Size Life off the album of Bright Size Life. And this is really exciting because in 2021, this recording was added to the Library of Congress to be selected for preservation in the National Recording Registry because they deemed it culturally, historically, or aesthetically significant to our culture. So, you know, next time you go to Library of Congress, listen to Pat Metheny.
Thank you.
So me and my dad share something in common. We're both really big Pat Metheny fans. The first jazz record he bought for me was the Pat Metheny Unity Group, Kin. And he also took me to my first Pat Metheny show at Ravinia, and we rocked out there for 3 hours, and the rest of the crowd left, so it was pretty funny. The diehard fans, all 15 of us, rushed the stage. Ishmael was there. He was there. Sorry. But yeah, I just wanted to share that. My dad has an awesome Pat Metheny vinyl collection that I got to grow up with that he let me steal, just like he let me steal this guitar and also this guitar strap and also that amp and his pedal board. And he also bought me all the clothes that I'm currently wearing. So please give a round of applause for my dad. I like incorporating his tunes that he says are his favorite. And at some point he said he liked New Chautauqua. So that's what we're gonna play now. And it's gonna be a bass feature. So yeah.
Thank you.
So that was New Chautauqua. And now we're going to move on to a tune called Say the Brother's Name. And Pat Metheny's kind of worked on music projects with interesting people. And this is probably one of the more interesting groupings. Piano player, Brad. I don't know how to say his last name. It's like, yeah, that. Yeah, it's a good tune. Gonna feature Trevor pretty much, and it's an Iwi feature.
Thank you.
Now we welcome Juliet back to the stage. The next set of tunes is going to be off another iconic Pat Metheny pairing, Pat Metheny and Lyle Mays. Lyle unfortunately passed away this past year, but I highly recommend checking out his music. And together they led the Pat Metheny group. Lyle's name wasn't in it, but they co-wrote a lot of the music. And this is The Girls Next Door. Thank you. Our next tune is called Phase Dance. It's one of the first Pat Metheny tunes this group learned. It's also one of my favorite tunes too. It's off the first Pat Metheny group album. And I always say, at least for jazz musicians that want to check out his music, to start with first Pat Metheny group album and first Pat Metheny album, and you can't go wrong. So yeah, this is Phase Dance. Okay, this is our last tune of the night, which means we get to do thank yous. Thank you, everyone, for coming. Great seeing you all. Thank you for Paul Pareles, your trio, playing at the beginning. And we have Terry, who is at the front door taking money. Thank you to him. Thank you to Jose for selling drinks and making sure stuff runs smoothly. Our artist is Betty, she's been drawing all night, so make sure you check out her stuff. We have Kenny on sound, making sure we sound good. And then we have Yadin, who's been running our live stream for all the folks that are watching at home. So that's pretty neat. And then I'd like to thank Chris, who's in the room now. I'd like to thank him for having us play. I've said this last time I played here, but I think it's really cool and awesome that he lets younger musicians play here. Usually it's pretty hard to get into jazz clubs and whatnot, and Chris has really nurtured a scene, and I think that's awesome and that everyone should continue to support Fulton Street Collective. Okay, and here's the band one last time. We have Vinny on bass. TJ on drums, driving us all night long. We have the lovely and beautiful Juliet Gardner playing trumpet. And then we have Trevor Hill playing so many instruments tonight. All right, last tune, here we go. Thank you.
Gwen's Pat Metheny Project. TJ Thompson on drums. Vinny Cabot, bass. Trevor Hill, saxophone. Juliet Gardner, trumpet. And leading the crew tonight on guitar, Amy Newrocky. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. We're back here tomorrow night with Gabriella Alamana Quartet. Same station, same time. Please come back for that. It's that time of the night to be generous. If you're in the house, we're going to turn up the lights. We're going to put Betty's artwork on the blast door over there, which is available for you to buy. If you're at home, please look on the lower right-hand side of your screen, and please be generous and kind and tip the band. Donate to the artist. If you like what you've seen here, you can donate to Fulton Street Collective. This is very much a collaborative effort here at Fulton Street. We have Kenny Claymire on sound tonight. Yell at Kim on video. Jose Valle on everything. That's it for tonight. We are back tomorrow night. We'll see you then. Until then, get vaccinated. Stay safe.
Okay.